Best friends Bobby and Kevin are throwing around a baseball in the park when they are suddenly knocked out and abducted by an unknown evil. Hours later, Bobby comes to in the trunk of a car, his arms and legs bound with rope. Scared and confused, he manages to free himself and makes a run for it, until he hears Kevin's screams coming from somewhere inside the house. Refusing to leave his buddy behind, Bobby decides to take matters into his own hands and becomes a one-boy rescue crew. This story about two best friends fighting for survival after being abducted is often misguided and filled with inconsistent messaging. The very brief flashback does little in the way of character development, essentially just showing us what we already know. It's inconsequential, a sight that would have done better with simply being omitted, and thus allowing us to just infer how these boys were grabbed. It's also frustrating type of dumb moves from both victims and perpetrators that artificially keeps undercooked horror plots cranking along. This movie is the type of film that will have you screaming suggestions to Bobby that he refuses to take. While Bobby's age could account for some of his poorer choices, the second kidnapper's behavior is so nonsensical she becomes little more than a boogeyman. These writing lapses are really frustrating. Perplexingly, the movie decides to make some blatant parallels to The Shining, lifting specific scenes from one of the most iconic horror films ever made. The filmmakers also had to plant their partisan flag. They could just let evil be evil without pointing at a specific group like they do in this film. There's seemingly no reason behind these choices. There's also ties to conspiracy theory nonsense. On the other hand, the strong part of the movie is in the acting, especially the child performance. The production quality also quite good. At least it's above average. It's the script that is the culprit, the one that destroys the movie. Overall, we do not recommend this movie at all.